If it isn't a ki arrow, its point is coated with a poison that rapidly circulates through the body, slowing the wounded until they are completely turned to stone. Is but a mere bone. Most would call that materia, but it is far more than a magic stone. It is a crystallized collection of the planet's memories and knowledge. Pleased to see that you're enjoying yourself.
Who wakes us from our slumber?
That specter, you thought, was a fallen key. Even in death, their lingering enmity manifests as such. They who wander in search of retribution.
That's kind of pathetic.
Do not be so quick to denigrate your enemies, nor make light of their plight. Consider this statue. It has been placed in this chamber for a reason. Handle it with the utmost care.
I will.
Deliver unto us the remnants of our past.
Interesting, because my first thought was, are we gonna make it out of this place alive?
Its decor is indeed the opposite of inviting.
These look like the statue I picked up.
If there is a reason for everything, then one could argue that everything has no reason. Regardless, you know what you must do, don't you?
Deliver unto us the remnants of our past. Restore them to their rightful place. Way
two legs here, you know.
The veil is intertwined with the Gi, for they first came to these lands many millennia ago. This sanctuary is proof of their persistence, for it was built to ensure that they never escaped.
But if they were sealed away thousands of years ago, how'd they break out and attack the veil?
That I cannot answer. Only the Gi themselves could. But enough about them. You are here to learn about yourself, Malaki. This cave serves as a boundary between our world and that of the Gi. It was vital to them and their plans. Were the Gi to seize control of it, the canyon would be doomed.
And the people.
When the Gi moved against us yet again, a certain watcher recalled this vulnerability.
Huh?
Since time was of the essence, he entered the cave without reinforcements. As he had feared, it was teeming with Gi, ready to descend upon the village. Determined to protect the Vale, he pounced from one foe to the next, felling all who dared oppose him.
Hold on. If there was a watcher who single-handedly saved the canyon, how come I've never heard of that?
For now, you should focus on your own struggles with the Gi. Their malice grows more potent.
Eons?
Do not allow fear to take hold of your heart. You are your own master, Anakin. You and no one else. Never forget that. Look through the crevasse at the gates beyond. Pass through all to complete your trial. But that's easier said than done.
How are we supposed to open this thing?
How indeed? Ideas, Lanarchy?
Thank you.
blind them with your brilliance.
I only got two legs here, you know.
We came upon before were built to imprison the key. This, however, was built to provide the Cetra with a means to commune with them.
Commune with them? Why would the Cetra do that? The Gi were the enemy.
Good and evil friend and foe. Dichotomy is not set in stone, as mutable as the winds. But for now, Anarchy, let us concentrate on the matter at hand. Clearing a path to the truth. Watcher fought his way here alone, and in his bravery took upon himself the burden of our...
Yeah. straight to him! Yeah. It hurts, don't it?
Quite the formidable fighter.
Sure have. So, does this mean I passed the test?
I'm afraid that decision is not mine alone to make. Let us consult with one more qualified. The Watcher of the Veil fought valiantly and offered up his life in defense of our home. As you see, he still watches over us to this very day.
Wait, is that Seto? My father? No, there's no way.
The poisoned arrows of the Gi transformed his body into stone, and there he has stood ever since, his watch eternal, our savior.
What about my mom? Did she know what had happened to him?
Why, of course she did. It was, after all, she and Seto who asked me to seal off the cave.
But why? Why did she never tell me the truth?
Because she knew that if she did, You would attempt to seek your father out all by yourself. Your parents strove to keep our Vale safe. But there is one thing they fought even harder to protect. You, Nanaki, their son.
She was afraid because I was too small and weak.
Back then, perhaps, but not anymore, heavens no. You've become a fine warrior in your own right. And that is precisely why I brought you here. But this is not where your journey is meant to end, my dear boy. You must leave the Vale once more.
But I'm a watcher now. I gotta protect our home, like he did.
Listen to me, Nanaki. When I first heard your friend's emphatic warnings, I dismissed them outright. No more than the ravings of misguided youth. When you've lived as long as I have, you start to believe you've seen it all, that no surprises remain. But I realize now how very foolish I have been. The eyes that I thought saw the world clearly have grown blind to new possibilities.
But...
I would hate to impede your progress any further. I bid you leave, Nanaki, before, like me, you become inured to your own ignorance. With sharper eyes and keener ears, go forth and in my stead seek the great truths of our world. Look after him for me.
Don't worry. We will.
You failed this trial, my boy. Continue your training and try again. Are you up to the task, Nanaki?
You bet I am. After all... I am Nanaki, Watcher of Cosmo Canyon, and son of Seto, protector of our Vale!
My thanks, Seto. You are as magnanimous as ever. The warrior Nanaki, and you, the Cetra. Come with me.
Turn of events, indeed.
We'll back you up, Patutao.
No. This one's free.
Can anyone explain to me why we're even taking this detour? Mission to secure the material we need to, you know, save our homeland?
How can you talk like that in a place like this? I'm scared out of my wits here.
I don't know. This Gi dude's too nice to freak me out.
He may act nice, but who knows what he's planning. Stay alert.
Beyond. Now let us begin our journey.
Not so fast. What's in it for us? Unless it's materia, you can count me out.
How strange you should mention materia. My people are also in search of it.
Longer if I could, but I'll be back soon. I promise. Maybe try swaying with the rocking of the boat?
I wanna move less, not more.
Didn't seem to mind when you jumped aboard.
Only cause he mentioned materia.
Be quiet. The planet is listening.
And what's wrong with that?
Anything that reaches the planet's ears, in due time, reaches those of the Cetra. Unfortunately, the Cetra are not a tolerant people.
Excuse me, am I intolerant too? I'm Cetra.
You are indeed one of them, by lineage alone. You know not of their history. That has been lost to time.
Their history?
Consider your ignorance a blessing. The Cetra's past is fraught with horror and sorrow.
So there I am, on the ground, bleeding out, watching everything go dark. Thinking, this is it. This is how it ends. Only, it isn't. Suddenly, the wind picks up out of nowhere. It tugs at me so hard, it feels like it's tearing my soul right out of my body. Next thing I know, I'm back in the orphanage. But nobody can tell me who found me or how I got there. It's a miracle.
Sounds like what happened to me. Whole freaking army unloading on my position. I'm outnumbered, and the next, I'm alone.
None of it makes any sense. I somehow managed to beat the odds and wake up here, alone. Why in the hell did fate pick me?
Can't think that way.
Can't not think that way. Their luck runs out, but mine doesn't. I'm the only one who gets a pass. And now that it's just me, what am I supposed to do? You know?
Yeah, I get it.
Hey, come with me.
Sure, but why?
I'll explain on the way.